Hello there, I'm Jamie. Welcome to another session of Vista Explore Services. In this session, I'll quickly show you how to deal with heavy objects in your scene by simply converting them into V-Ray proxies. Proxies often help users navigate through the heavy scenes and render complex objects very fast. Before converting objects to proxies, make sure to attach the relevant objects first. To create a proxy, select the sofa first. Right-click and choose the V-Ray Mesh Export. In a V-Ray Mesh Export dialog, you have the first option, which is the folder. This function allows users to set the location of where the proxy mesh will be saved into. To set the location, simply click on a browse toggle and choose the location to save the V-Ray mesh. The file location allows users to rename the selected object in the scene. By default, it uses the name of the selected object in the scene, plus the file extension .vraymesh. Next, enable the function to automatically create proxies and press OK. As you can see, a proxy of the sofa was automatically created. Also, the name vray proxy was automatically added before the original name. Open the Modify panel to check the proxy settings. In the Mesh File section, you can see the location link where the mesh file was saved into, and by clicking on the Browse button. The Scale function allows users to scale the proxy object up or down if and when necessary. The value of 1.0 is often OK. In Display Group, you have many options. By default, the display is set to Preview File Faces. However, you can set the display mode to Bound in Box, Preview from Files, Preview from File Faces, Point, and Show Whole Mesh. You can also choose to import as mesh if you want to make changes to the mesh. The remaining settings are pretty much self-explanatory. When copying proxies, make sure they are instances as opposed to copies, otherwise your images will take longer to render. This 3ds Max scene is available as part of a new course I've recently created on my blog, for my Patreon supporters and for udemy.com. The course is full HD and with subtitles. The links are down below and I hope you find them useful. Thanks for watching, like this video, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.